Now let's go into details regarding functions. So there are three ways to enter functions into your worksheet. So for that you can go for page 103 example, figure table 3.75 on page 103, topic 3.2.2. So we have got some built-in functions just like we used the sum function earlier. So how do we apply this function? Now in this table you can see that we want to calculate the average of these values, okay? So one way is by typing from the keyboard. So in the next cell you type equal sign and then you write A and V, equal sign then A, V. As soon as you do that, you will be presented with this drop-down menu with a lot of function names arranged alphabetically. So from that you can either select average or you can write the whole word average by yourself. Once you do that, you can either add up the starting bracket and start giving the references of these cells, okay, or you can just click on from the mouse and by pressing the control key and select these cells and release the control key. And when you are done selection with the cells, then you can close the border and press enter key. And that's how you will apply these formulas. So the other way is going to the menu, okay, and selecting the auto sum function. Same thing, you can go to the page 104 and look at the table 3.77 and look at the auto sum highlighted in the screenshot. From there you can select the same functions, okay, like sum, average. Just click on the sum symbol and auto sum and you will be presented with a drop down menu and you will be able to select average function, min, max and sum. You have to apply all these functions on this test data. So once you're done with it, move on to the next topic. Now next topic is to keep the previous data saved so that it can be used further. So you can use the previous table, okay, or you can create the table presented in table 3.81 on page 106. So now you are ready to apply graphics. So by now you are able to insert different functions and see their outputs. So now we are able to generate graphs regarding these functions. So why do we use graphics in data representation in MS Excel? So graphs allow us to see the data trends or how our data appears graphically in MS Excel. So for that we use the graph representation or charts. So bar chart is the most commonly used chart as shown in this window. So to apply that, follow the steps as mentioned on page 106. Go to insert tab and then select charts group. From the charts group you can select the different column command and different kind of charts, pie charts and so on and so forth. So once you have done that, this page will appear on your screen. You can click anywhere, okay, and drag it, move along with your data wherever you want it to be placed. So you can also right click over here and change its name, charts name and so on and so forth. So now once you have done with it, now practice with different kinds of tables, create them and generate graphs and see how they appear beside the text. Next topic is topic 3.2.4 of textbook page 107, manipulating and formatting data. So first function in manipulating and formatting data is data filtering or filtering data. So what is this function? Why do we need it? For that, students, first you have to create this table on page 107, figure 3.85. So after you have done that, you will notice that there are some students' class names mentioned here. So for example, we want to see only the students that are present in class 9B. So for that, we want to apply some kind of filter to see only students related data to 9B. So to apply that, we will use the filter data command. So for that, you have to select this whole data, okay, just like it appears in the screenshot. Then you will go to select data tab on the ribbon and click the filter command and in the sort filter group. And from the drop down menu, arrow will appear in the header of each column. So once you go through this process, you will be presented with this screenshot, okay, with this pop-up menu, okay. So what you will do, you will be presented with these values over here, okay. You can look at your screenshot of your book as well. Now here you will only check the 9B class, okay. You will select the 9B and leave other unchecked. Once then done, you will press OK key, okay, and then you will see that only data related to 9B will be shown. All the students 1, 2, 3, 4 values will be shown. Other will hide. Actually, they are not deleted. They will be hidden from your site, okay. You can carefully, if you spot this series after applying this value, the row numbers, you will see some of the rows skipping. So those cells will be hiding behind the screen. So you can repeat the process and undo the checkbox and leave the click on all the checkboxes, and you will be presented with all the data again. So this deals with the filtering data command. Next up is the function data validation. So just like before, students, as you have learned data filtering, so if you want the user to be restricted of entering data into your sheet and you don't want user to be entering wrong values, Excel provides with you a feature which is called data validation. Only valid type of data will be entered into your sheet. Other will not be entered and discarded. So for that, you have to create this table, or you can use the previous table for this purpose, okay. So once you have created this table, okay, select the cells under the age heading and do not enter these values yet, okay, before applying the function. So keep this cell empty, just select it. After you have selected, go through the steps to apply the function. So for example, here we are interested in the ages of the students. So we will be entering the ages within the limit. For example, say from between 12 and 16. We are interested in values between 12 and 16. So for that, to restrict the user, we will go to the data validation command in the data tools group. And then in the allow heading section, we will click on the drop-down menu. And from there, we'll select the source. And once you go through this process, you will be presented with the data validation menu, okay. Once this is open, then you can click under the allow heading, okay. You click on this cell value and it will show a drop down menu, okay. From here you can either select the whole number or decimal number, select any of these, and then you will be shown this area which will give you this value, which is says between minimum and maximum. So in the bar under the minimum, you will write the value. What is the minimum value that we decided? 12. So we'll write 12 over here, and under the maximum you will write the 16 value. Once you have done that, press okay. So you will be presented with this screen again. So in these cells, you start and entering the values. So test the value. For example, if you enter 10, it will give you an error and show a pop-up menu which will present you with the message that you entered the wrong value. Similarly, if you go beyond value 16, this will do the same. So this is how you apply data validation. Students, next is the topic of protecting and unlocking the worksheet. So sometimes we need to protect our worksheet from accidental or intentional data loss. So for that, we can apply protection to our worksheet, which enables it to be viewed just like a PDF file. If you have seen a PDF file is also available on the internet. You can download it and see that you cannot make changes to a normal PDF file. So it's similar to that. But and there is another feature that Excel allows you, that you can show or some of, you can log some of the Excel sheets area or cells, and some of the cells you can let free for changes. Okay, to make changes to be made to that area. So for that, you apply protecting and unlocking the sheet feature. So perform practical practice regarding this topic as mentioned on page 110 of your textbook. Next topic is the topic of conditional formatting. So students, just like previously we have done filtering data and data validation, conditional formatting is another very cool feature of MS Excel, where if you want to see your data just like is shown on page 110 in table 3.93, that if you want your data to be seen with different colors, you can apply the conditional formatting option to see visual appearance of your data with appealing features. Okay, for example, if you want in this table that I talked about, table 3.93, students who have got lower grades or lower marks than 33 are highlighted with red color, okay, showing that they have failed in the subject. Similarly, you can go for the students which have got the higher marks. You can change the color to blue or green with the higher marks. So you can use the conditional formatting feature for this purpose. So students, this concludes your MS Excel topic. So perform all the practicals related to it. By now you might be familiar with those things that that you don't understand properly. So do more practice regarding it, and you can ask questions later in the class. Thank you.